subject, of course. Well, a lot of us are very familiar with the music of Marvin Hatley as it applies to the background music, background songs that we hear Vince Giordano play all the time, and that you heard outside played by Ronnie Hazelhurst. But what we'd like to give you tonight is a little sampling of the songs that were featured in some of the Laurel and Hardy films. I think probably my favorite song out of any Laurel and Hardy film was sung in Pardon Us. It was called Lazy Moon. It was written in the early 1920s. It was in the style of the old minstrel ballads. And as such, was generally performed in blackface and with a sort of a derisive characteristic dialect. Babe sang in blackface in a picture, in fact. I'm going to forgo the dialect and the blackface and offer you, hopefully, your pleasure, Lazy Moon. Now, if you recall the setting, it is dusk, the field hands are relaxing after a long day's toil, and the sky is being searched for the light of the moon to provide the light for the strolls down the river's bank.
Lazy moon, come out soon, make my poor heart beat warmer, light the way, bright as day, for my sweet little charmer. Now she's to meet me in the lane tonight, if the sky is bright and clear. Oh moon, don't keep me waiting here tonight, watching and awaiting, heart palpitating, longing for my little lady love. Lazy moon, lazy moon, why don't you show your face upon the hill? Lazy moon, come out soon, you can make me happy if you will. Now when my lady sees your face a-peeping, then I know her promise she'll be keeping. Tell me what's the matter, are you sleeping? Lazy moon.
What are these dozens of songs? What are these examples you have to demonstrate this genius and also hopefully entertain our audience at the same time.
Are you kidding? Listen to this. Now, Charlie Chase was a lot like Elvis Presley.
Wait a minute.
No, wait a minute. Let me just write mine. Because Charlie Chase and Elvis Presley would sing a song at any given moment about anything at any given time. For instance, he was teaching the Little Rascals one time. He was a teacher. Now, a normal teacher who was teaching mathematics would just teach about mathematics. But would Charlie Chase teach mathematics only?
No.
Listen to this one. He not only taught mathematics to the kids, but he gave them a lesson in life as well. 1 times 1 equals only 1. But 1 and 1 are 2. And a simple thing like a wedding ring will prove this most untrue. 'Cause if you add 1 to another 1, pretty soon they'll multiply. And the 2 you see will soon be 3 if the 2 dear are you and I. Hi, hi.
Hi, hi.
If the 2 dear are you and I. Now, normally, someone will propose to another, but would Charlie Chase just...
I'm already.
Well, I'm happy to marry too.
Okay.
And we just propose. But would Charlie Chase just propose?
No.
Charlie Chase, when he was courting Rosina Lawrence in a particular film, sang a song to her while he was courting her. He sang this to her.
Listen, dear, have you got a date tomorrow? If you haven't, I'll make a date with you. Promise, dear, that you won't be late tomorrow. We'll have an awful lot of things to do. So get to bed and get a lot of rest. 'Cause tomorrow you will want to look your best. Let's make it a big day. We'll start out at 9:30, do things in a big way. First I'll ask you to be mine. And when your pa has cussed us and your ma has said okay, we'll hurry to the justice, do our shopping right away. Don't overlook a thing, get a wedding ring and a platinum one in that. I'll get my trousers pressed, get a fancy vest and a brand new derby hat. We'll make a payment on a wedding gown. We might as well hire a plaid, so what do you say? Let's make it a big day.
It's been there all the day, and the little Dutch mill's on the little Dutch hill, so everything's okay. The flies are on the ointment, I look at them to lot. I never knew what's coming next, but I put them on the spot. The bird is in her gilded cage, the cat is in a fight, and I'm in the doghouse, and I can't go out tonight. The old woman's in the shoe, the stars are in the blue, the woodpecker's in the woodpile, and the oyster's in the stew. The jack is in the cotton, The cat is in the box, and in case you have forgotten, oh, the ship is on the rocks. The flies are on that table, but I am an expert shot. They come in from the stable, and I put them on the spot. The baby's in a little cradle, tucked in nice and tight, and I'm in the doghouse, and I can't go out tonight. At the end of the night, and there is Felix Knight.
The Jack in the Box, that's great. Stay, You're absolutely right. Charlie Chase, from any man who could go before a collective audience of 50 million Americans and sing songs like that and remain on contract has got to be more than an average talent. I agree.
I'm really not done. In all seriousness, yes, most of Charlie Chase's songs were silly. Most of his films came out in the Depression. And while Charlie Chaplin in 1936 was preaching about smiling,
I knew he'd get Chaplin in there!
Charlie Chase was preaching about smiling during despair and the Depression 6 years before. Smile when the raindrops fall, dear. Smile till the clouds roll by. Just remember.
Let me talk about this thing here. We know the reason they liked it. Because they was happy little tunes that went deedle by deedle. They was complicated symphonies that went boom pa boom pa boom pa.
Diddle 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 is better than.
Is better than boompa, oompa, boompa! Exactly what I've been saying.
Okay.
So, if you take a music that goes diddle diddle diddle, or you play it in a moving picture that has diddle diddle people, you not only get harmony in music, you get harmony in pictures.
Just a minute, Professor. I think I follow you. I just have one question.
Yeah.
What are diddle diddle peoples?
Oh, I'm so disappointed in you. You know, you little people, like those rascal gangs. Un Oliver and Hardy. Un Charlie mit der Glashes und der Skinos, who sings too darn many songs as far as I'm concerned. Mit them go little dino little music. You wouldn't play little dino little music with Lionel Barrymore or Orson Welles, would you? No, mit them you play boom pa boom pa boom pa. In the rascal gangs, you play little dino little.
Okay.
Und so. When you have deal-a-dial music with deal-a-dial peoples, and you put them both in deal-a-dial pictures, you get boom-pa-oompa box office! And that's big bucks. That makes the boys in the front orifice very happy. Oh boy, you get 7-year contracts. You get a Spanish bungalow with a swimming pool on Mulholland Driveway. And you get a front table in the Romanovs. You get your name in the Weller Parsons column once a week. Words of interest spread malicious lies about your sex life on the front pages of every radio across the continent. It's a rotten, stinking business.
Professor.
I hate it.
Professor.
And why do I do it for that?
Professor.
What deedle, deedle, deedle. Hey, why do we sit here talking about this trivia when there's bombs going off in Yugoslavia?
Professor.
Anyway, you get a general idea.
Yes, thank you. Thank you very much. Professor, I am tone deaf. That's a general idea about the success of the music of Hal Road Studios. And we would like to conclude now, ladies and gentlemen, with a medley of songs from Hal Road Studios.
While down on a desert island, underneath the beauty of the stars, I strayed upon some maidens who was strumming on their guitars. A hula maid was dancing, and I knew I found a paradise. This is what I told her when I gazed into her eyes. Honolulu, baby, where'd you get those eyes? And a dark complexion, I just idolized. Honolulu, baby, where'd you get that smile? And the pretty red lips, and that sunny smile. When you start to dance, go to the trance, then shake it up and down. You shake a little here, shake a little there. Well, you got the boys going to town. Honolulu, baby, sure know your stuff. Honolulu, baby, gonna call your bluff.
Let me hear you whisper, that you love me too. Keep that love light binding in your eyes so blue. Let me call you sweetheart. The idiot down here doesn't know when to stop. I'm in love with you, you great big hamburger, you.
Thank you.
much, folks. It was a little trifle. We didn't have much time to put it together, but we wanted to offer you something.
Great.
And now... And I'm going to ask Lois Laurel Hawes to come up and introduce our cinematic presentation for the evening.
Right. Wonderful.
Good job.
When my dad was making Chum at Oxford, he had a birthday. And Dick Courier and some of the people put together some snippets for more or less, well, it was for our birthday present, but just sort of a nonsensical happening, and presented it to my father. And this is the only copy in existence. UCLA has a 35 mil but no sound, and they have been trying get the soundtrack from us, and we've held out because I don't sing and I don't dance, but when I go somewhere I can take this film. So it's my claim to fame. Anyway, there is it's a very good possibility that next year the new Treasures will be coming out with a cassette with Zenobia, some home movies of Zenobia that were taken by Mabel Landon's family down at the Howard Studio while they were making Zenobia, and possibly an interview with June Lang and Harry Langdon Jr. And then on the back, also on this cassette, we will include That's That. So that might be available next year. You will see that this is, you know, it's just a sort of a put together, a little bit of this, a little bit of that. But everybody, much to our, at least to my amazement, everywhere I go, they want us to bring it. So you'll see it now. Jack's about ready to roll.
Almost.
Right?
Almost.
Almost. Okay. Oh, okay. And you'll notice some. Anyway, as I say, it seems to be just an intriguing thing. It doesn't make any sense. You'll notice bits and pieces from the film. And it's just a fun thing. And I hope you all enjoy it.
Thank you.
much as a pound. Seguramente. Si puedo probar que tú eres el editor.
Thank you. Thank you.